Well, there's no way out of here. Let's go back.
There's no way out there.
Who are you?
Where did you come from?
All in good time.
Look, how do we get out of here?
All in good time.
I'm in a hurry.
It can wait.
I really can't wait. I have an appointment.
Sit. All of you. Please sit down. Sit down. I assure you I have a purpose.
What purpose?
Why did you come in here?
I don't know. I was just driving by and something made me.
And what are your plans when you leave here?
Plans?
Plans.
And all through the house.
Described as a homicidal maniac, has escaped from the hospital for the criminally insane. He is 6'3" tall, 210 pounds, dark eyes, bald, and may be wearing a Santa Claus costume taken from a shop in Burley. All residents of the county are warned to be on the lookout for this man and to phone the police if they see him. We now continue our program of carols for Christmas Eve.
See my wife and children.
And then? And then? And then?
Reflection of death.
Goodbye, darling.
Don't forget to ring me when you get there.
I will. Goodbye, darling.
Bye. Drive carefully.
Yes, right.
So I see.
Should all be there by the time we get there.
Yeah.
Yes, I know that, darling. But we've both had to give up quite a bit, haven't we?
After the crash. Huh? And I was blinded.
Blinded?
And Carl was killed.
Killed?
2 years ago.
So that is why you were in a hurry? To leave your wife and children?
What do you mean? How do you... Who are you?
Poetic justice.
What sort of game are you playing?
Game?
You're trying to frighten us in some way. What do you want?
To show you something. Something in your own mind. Something you are capable of doing.
I don't want to know.
Oh, but you must know. You must.
To the kids. He does it every year on his birthday. I don't know how you stand.
Stand what?
Living across the road from that man. He's a rubbish collector. A dustman. Places an eyesore. The toys he gives those kids, he finds in the rubbish heap and repairs. Why doesn't he sell out?
I've made him offers. He's sentimental about that old dump. Just he and his wife live there for whole married life, and now he wants to die there. Just as she did.
Well, it ruins the neighborhood and depreciates the value of our property. The inside must be like a pigsty.
He owns the place free and clear. Nothing we can do about it.
Bye-bye. See you tomorrow. Shut the gate. Bye-bye.
Isn't there?
Lots of mail for you today, Mr. Gibson.
Oh, funny. Thank you very much. Oh. Oh, very kind. My dear. Oh, it's not even Christmas, is it? Not that it makes any difference if it is or not. I'll be writing to it. Let's see. Valentine card. You're my only sweetheart. Will this be? Live in the country. Some people live in the town. Why don't you do us a service? Jump in the river.
Thank you.
don't like Grimstike.
Wish you were here.
What am I doing here? You'll see.
That's it, Ralph, I'm afraid. It's all gone.
Everything.
More than everything. You have debts. I did warn you, didn't I, not to use money that had been entrusted to you. The risks were far too great.
Ralph? Have you ever seen this writing that's inscribed on the bottom of this statuette?
Writing?
Hmm. Yes, here at the base.
Three wishes I give, and no more. It reminds me of a tale I once read. What was it?
We could pay all our debts.
The monkey's paw, that's what it was.
I wish...
I read it when I was at school.
I wish for lots and lots of money.
Oh, no, no.
Ralph? Dead? Charles, I wished for lots and lots of money. Ralph warned me not to.
No, that's a coincidence.
No, it's no coincidence. That statuette. It gave us three wishes. I used one of them to wish for lots and lots of money. Now I'm going to wish for Ralph back.
Don't look. His body was mangled in the crash.
Mangled? It wasn't mangled. Mr. Jason died of a heart attack at the wheel.
I wished for him back, as he was immediately before the accident. But he was already dead. Dead from a heart attack, so the accident didn't kill him. Now, I don't want him to die ever. I want him moving, breathing, talking, alive. Now, forever.
Don't you realize he's been embalmed? His brains are filled with embalming fluid burning into him.
Oh, no!
Oh, for God's sake, East! Help me!
No, no, in it, don't! Kill him. Every piece of him is alive still. Alive and suffering.
Blind alleys.
What's more important is what you will see.
But who are you? What do you want with us?
To warn you of what may happen.
I don't care about your warnings. I want to get out of here.
Very well. But you should heed the warning.
Good morning. My Major William Rogers. I've been appointed your new superintendent here and take up my duties today. I've had considerable experience in dealing with men as an officer in the Army. I promise you I will do this job to the best of my ability. I hope we'll all get along well. If there are any complaints, I shall be pleased to deal with them in my office at any time. Good morning.
Yes?
Turned off each evening at 2000 hours. It's customary to knock on the door of a private office. What do you want? Can't you see I'm having my lunch?
Collection complete.
What is all this? I'm on my way to a new job. I don't know why I stopped here. I do.
Now you may go. I wasn't warning you, but telling you why you are here for all eternity. Ah!
And now, who's next?